going to talk about what different topic might be more cast getting broadcasting environment. So my work as a system designer in company Ithaca. Ithaca is a company who owns a national broadcasting network and operates it. So we are having around and PLS network and most of our services are based on IP multicast. So I'm briefly going to tell you something what we have done and what we have learned during these years. Some background information of broadcasting services. One is obviously one to all distribution and as the name says, broadcasting, but multicast is sophisticated way to do it. And one use case in retail systems and data center networks, where it's convenient to have one screen available for many receivers and devices and pick it up anywhere in the network. And we are also receiving signals from remote sites. This contribution and more it's also global operations. And traditionally, TV and radio services are mostly static focus on services, but it is maybe changing now a little bit, at least because streams are going to be more personalized and customized, like individual streams. And multicast routing and IP multicast is not a new thing. Protocols has been around about 20 years. And in digital, we have started with mobile TV service 10 years ago. I've been involved the last 9 years, and it has been quite hard getting to work. And I'm talking IP before networks only because the broadcasting world is not ready for IPv6. We are still learning IPv4 multicast. And it's a long way to IPv6 world. Okay, then some technical details. Multicast is based on being fast mode and IGNT protocols specifically. And the current standard is to use BIM source specific multicast, which means both does all the job and explicitly joins to source group address and source IP address. So the network is very simple and easy. And there is no more dynamic RPN registration process on BTS, 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 or NSTP protocols at all. Very, very easy and simple. So specific multicast has some limitations that go in both devices because not all of them support it. IGNT version 3, and you can do still in so specific multicast, but have IGNT version 2 compatible LANs through SSM mapping on Twitter, but it's not very convenient, but it's true, it's very labor intensive. And it really depends on the application, how it works with software multicast. It's dynamic, very dynamic configurations and many progressions supported. The address infinites. Basically, the whole multicast range is available and usable with some restrictions. But I think what will be easier if you stick to default ranges or any sort of multicast and sort of specific ranges. There are plenty of addresses when used. No reason to save this. And personally, I would avoid first and left addresses of the subnets, just in case. And you have to remember also that the IPX and that is not overlaps some parts. So you have to plan where to go to this of IPX. Whereas that you have to see some examples, so overlapping. And the best practice is to use IP address management tools. Redis is a very handy tool for podcast. Address is also, you can name streams and Redis. And we are seeing more and more streaming, podcast streaming between different organizations, and it would be handy to have a unique address in so-called public addressing to avoid overlapping IP addresses. And this space is very limited. There is only block for those who have 16 bit alias number. And you can directly calculate your own address space, C class of on-cost addresses based on your alias number. Of course, who don't have 16 bit alias number, they have to use broad ranges. And the software with multicast can reuse the same group address with different sources and even different port numbers, but it can introduce some complexity and possible troubles also. Routers have two different roles currently assigned to them. One is a forwarder and one is identity querier. They are not necessarily the same router. And you have to remember that the multicast forwarder router is not always the same as the unicast gateway. It could be different topology. And the best practice to assign plans lowest IP address to router interface because it is dynamically assigned to IGNP querier role. And the IGNP protocol itself is quite complex or very complex. And most problems lie here because host implementation and configuration is every time different and it really depends on the coding and application support. And IGNP itself has a complex set of timers and I don't really want to touch them. It's best practice to use default settings because it affects all of them at the same time. And then switch network. IGNP snooping is good to have on, obviously reduces flying, but gives you also visibility to to your own which groups are subscribed to this force resource. Not every switch supports IGNP snooping per email, and so specific version is not well supported IGNP snooping. There are also problems with flying between cross-complete ports to the species if you have a point for VLAN on both things. And you can really distinct what is bad, what is good, how cross traffic, and with storm control profiles, you eventually have to exclude or not cross traffic from profiles.
Personal favorite, NPLS. So if you want to do native NPLS forwarding multicast, your options are push multicast directly to LSP or use VPN services. And protocols, signaling protocols are LDP or RSVP. And RSVP is the most versatile, gives you
almost all options to do multicast tree of your choice. You can include all traffic engineering and that to your options. I haven't used L2 VPNs, but the solution is hierarchical VPLS. And my choice is L3 VPN, which is regular L3 VPN with multicast enhancements. Legacy method was wrapped roles and which uses pin tunnels in the core network. But current standard is next-gen NVPN, which is based on DCP signaling in the core and PIM islands and PE routers, VPN-specific PIM islands, PE routers, and RSVP or LDP builds point-to-multipoint LSPs between PE routers. And NVPN also supports extranet configuration, which is sometimes very handy. You can leak routes between different VPNs to build different kinds of topologies. And default action in NVPN is to flood every multicast traffic to every PE which is participating in that specific VPN. If you want to avoid that, you can use selective provider tunnels, which introduces 10 more RSVP tunnels and state into a network and quickly can lead to scalability issues. And this RSVP scalability is a really big topic. And you can avoid it by using request reduction and also disabling unnecessary tunnels in the core. And this MVP configuration is quite complex and hard to manage. And as I said, we are seeing more and more multicast streaming between different organizations, and which is hard to do, and we have two different models. Yeah.
5 minutes,
okay. Yeah, we have static and dynamic models. And this static means that we are statically pushing out multicast without sharing any protocol information between different organizations. So this is very reliable and static configuration. And dynamic configuration is based on PIM protocol and dynamic routing, so this has network level redundancy. And management part of multicast, I think multicast is something mysterious for many people, but it's really quite easy and simple. You just enable two protocols and everything is working. But some knowledge is needed to understand the operation because it's fundamentally different than unicast. And my advice is to use L3 segmentation as much as possible because then you have a visibility to network what is happening in your routers and how traffic is flowing. And routers itself has quite good tools to see what is happening inside a box. And modern routers have also data plane video monitoring tools which can measure streams and quality. But we still lack of big picture end-to-end visibility to streams and routing domain. As I said, operating is quite easy and simple. Biggest problems are in host devices and host talking to routers. This is the complex part and very hard. Finally, future of a multicast. I see that is some kind of love-hate thing. Some think multicast is very useful and some consider it worthless. It depends maybe on the industry or
or use cases. But multicast has real life use cases, mostly efficient UDP based transport like live streaming and mass updates, but still inside in one administrative domain. And what are the obstacles of using multicast? Obviously internet, because it's unicast world, and as I said, streams are getting more and more personalized with new services inserted into the streams. This is also like unicast world, and MPLS multicast features are supported only in big boxes and expensive boxes, so we have limitation in hardware, also in software. Public space is very limited, and the interoperability is always hard between different organizations and different networks, different devices. There are still possibilities, some new protocols, AMT, automatic multicast tunneling, tunnels multicast through unicast networks. This is old thing. Some big companies even use it, and the beer is a newer one. It's this bit indexed explicit replication method of transporting multicasting service provider network without protocol state information. And the mobile networks, LTE broadcast, has been launching a couple of years now, and finally 5G will have native multicast support. And SDN is also option for building programmable multicast networks with open flow switches or BGP link state in MPLS network. But multicast internet will never have multicast enabled. I think multicast remain backend protocol inside one domain. But we still do multicast peering or streaming between different organizations, so it would be convenient to have a multicast peering point somewhere, at least locally, and the ISP could be a place to meet. And if we are continuing using multicast, tools must also evolve, better serve us who uses it. This is some kind of chicken egg problem. If we don't use multicast, we don't have proper tools either. And I'm hoping SDN world will bring us a better world if we still need multicast. That was my message. Catch me later if you have questions. Thank you.
Would you like to choose one pair? And I promise I won't tell anybody that you are standing in front of the XL.